Good morning everyone. Today we will do exercise 8.3. First question, tell whether profit or loss, also find profit percentage or loss percentage. Now I have written first part. In this part we have to tell whether there is a profit or loss, and we have to tell this also whether it's a profit percentage or loss percentage. See the question. Gardening shares bought rupees 250, sold for rupees 325. Students, now here it is written bought. It means that is cost price. You have to see the question carefully. If it is written bought, it means that is your cost price. Sold, it means that is your selling price. So this one is your selling price and this one is your cost price. First we have to see which one is bigger, whether cost price is bigger or selling price is bigger. Then we can say it's profit or loss. See, whenever we will start the solution, first we will write given. So we will write cost price. CP means cost price. Cost price of gardening share, that is rupees 250. Then SP means selling price, that is rupees 325. Now you can see from here that selling price is greater than cost price, because selling price is 325 and cost price is 250. So we will write 325 is greater than 250. It means selling price is greater than cost price. So if selling price is greater, we know that if SP is greater than CP, then it is a profit. And if CP is greater than SP, there is a loss. If both are equal, neither loss nor profit. So here, if selling price is greater than cost price, then there is a profit. Profit and gain, one and the same thing. And what is the formula of profit? That is selling price minus cost price. That we have done in introduction of this exercise. That is, formula of profit is selling price minus cost price. If selling price is greater, first we will write selling price. If cost price is greater, there is a loss, then we will write first cost price. So 325 minus 250, here is rupees 75. So profit is rupees 75. Now we have to tell profit percentage or loss percentage. So profit percentage. Now the formula of profit percentage is profit upon cost price, or you can write simply CP, that means cost price. Now profit is rupees 75, and what is the cost price? Cost price is 250 multiply with 100. This is the formula. We put the value instead of profit 75, instead of CP I have written 250. Now 0 will be cancelled. Now on the table of 25 1 the 25 25 3 the 75, 3 into 10, that is 30%. So our answer, students, whenever you will solve the question, that the end you have to write the answer. Profit is equal to rupees 75 and profit percentage, that is 30%. This is your first part. Now we will do second part of same question. B part of first question, a refrigerator bought for rupees 12,000 and sold at rupees 13,500. So for this, again we will write first the given cost price of refrigerator, that is rupees 12,000. So this one is the cost price, and now SP means selling price, that is rupees 13,500. Then we have to see which one is greater. 13,500 or 12,000. So SP is greater, so here we will write 13,500 is greater than 12,000. So this one is our SP, it means selling price is greater than cost price. Again, here is the profit. So we will write profit, and the formula of profit is selling price minus cost price. So 13,500 minus 12,000. So when we subtract it, we will get that is 13,500 minus 12,000. That is 1500 rupees. Always remember to put the sign of rupees. Then after that we have to find profit percentage. Same formula, profit upon CP multiply by 100. Now what is the profit? Then CP is 12,000 multiply by 100. 00 cancel. 1010 cancel. So on the table of 3, 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15, 0. Now on the table of 2, 2 2s are 4, 25. So here it comes 25 upon 2%. Or when you divide it in decimal, you will be get 12.5%. So this one our B part. Now C part. A cupboard bought means CP, that is cost price, that is 2500, and selling price is 3000. So which one is bigger? 3000. 3000 is bigger than 2500. So first we will write cost price of cupboard, that is rupees 2500. Then selling price of cupboard, that is rupees 3000. Now we have to see which one is greater. 3000 greater than 2500. It means SP is greater than CP. If SP is greater, it means there is a profit. And the formula of profit, SP minus CP. So 3000 minus 2500, we will get 500. So profit is rupees 500. We have to find profit percentage. P percentage means profit percentage. Formula, profit upon CP multiply by 100, put the value. 500 upon CP is this, multiply 100. Zero cancel. On the table of 25, I am going to cut. You can cut on the table of 5 two times. So answer is 20%. So profit is 20%. Now we will do D part. D part. A skirt bought rupees 250 and sold rupees 150. Again we will write first given, that is cost price of skirt. What is the cost price? Rupees 250. Now selling price of skirt, that is rupees 150. So which one is greater? CP is greater. Now in this question is a change. Now in what we have done in A, B, C part, at that part SP was greater, but here CP is greater. So we will write rupees 250 greater than 150. It means cost price is greater than selling price. If cost price is greater, there is a loss. Now formula of loss, here CP minus SP, not SP minus CP, that will come in negative and money will never in negative. So CP is 250 minus 150. When we subtract it, we will get 100. Now we will find L percentage means loss percentage. L upon CP, formula is same, but instead of profit, we will write loss. So loss is of rupees 100 and cost price is 250 multiplied by 100. Now 1010 cancel. On the table of 25, I am going to cancel. 25 fours are 100. 4 into 10, that is 40%. So answer is rupees 100 loss and loss percent is 40%. Next question. Question number 2. Convert each part of ratio 2%. We have to convert each part. Here it is in ratio 3:1. We have to convert first part into percentage and second part into percentage. For that, first we will add them. That is 3 plus 1. That we will write sum of parts. Sum of parts we can write. We can write total. We can write total also. Total number of parts. Sum of parts 3 plus 1, that is 4. Sum of parts 3 plus 1, 4. Then percentage of first part. This one is our first part and this one is our second part. So first we will write percentage of first part. Now see student, how we will find the percentage of first part. Here it is 3. First, what we will do, we will write first term, that is 3. And what is the total sum of parts, that are 4. And we have to make percentage. For that, we will multiply by 100. You know this thing, whenever we have to make percentage, we multiply with 100. And we want to remove, then we will divide with 100. Now, we will cancel it on the table of 4. 4 ones are 4. 4 twos are 8, 2 0, and 4 fives are 20. So 3 into 25, that is 75%. So it means 75% is the percentage of first part. That one is 3. Now percentage of second part. Second part. How we will do? Again, second part is 1. So first we will write 1. And what is the total? Total is 4. Sum of parts 100. Cancel it. 25. So here it is 25%. You can check it also. When you add them, when you add the percentage, you will get 100. Here 75 plus 25, that is 100. It means your answer is right. 100%. So answer is 75% and 25%. Two parts and 2%. Now B part, now here are 3. Now they are in 3:2, 3:5. First we will write total. You can write total also, you can write sum of the parts also. Both are right. Sum of parts, that is 2 plus 3 plus 5. Now 5 plus 3 8 8 plus 2 10. So first we will find first part. First part percentage. Now first part is 2. So 2 upon total 10. For the percentage we will write 100. 0 cancel. What it comes? 20%. So first part is 20%. Now second part. It means that is 3. What is the total? Total is 10. Sum of the parts. 100. 0 cancel. So here it is 30%. Now third part. Third part percentage. That is 5 upon 10 multiply 100. Cancel. That is 50. So what is the answer? 20% is 30. Then 50. Add them, you will get 100. If you will add them, you will get 100. So this one is our B part. Now C part, again 1:4. Add them. Sum of parts 1 plus 4 5. Percentage of first part. One upon 5 multiply by 100. Cancel it. You will get 20%. Here it is 1. So we will write 1. Total 5. 5 multiply 100. Cancel it. 20. then percentage of second part 4 4, total 5, multiply 100, cancel it 20, 20 into 4, 4 into 20 is 80%. And when you will add, you will get 100. 20 plus 80 is 100. So our answer is 20% is and 80% is. Now D part, sum of parts, 1 plus 2 plus 5, that is 8% of first part, that is 1 upon 8 multiplied by 100. Now we will cancel it on the table of 4. 25 upon 2% is. When you will convert in decimal, you will be get 12.5%. Then percentage of second part, here is 2 upon 8 multiplied by 100. 2 fours are 8, then 4, 25, so here it comes 25%. Then percentage of third part, that is 5 upon 8 multiplied by 100 on the table of 4. I am going to cancel. Now 25 into 5, 125 upon 2. Now when we cancel it, we will get 62.5%. When you will add them, you will get 100. So this one is a D part. Now we will do question number 3. Question number 3. The population of city decreased from 25,000 to 24,500. Find the percentage decrease. Students, now you can see here. Now first the population was 25,000. It means that one is our initial population. So initial population was 25,000. Now it decreased. Graph down. So after the decreasing, population is 24,500. We have to tell how much percentage decrease. There is a formula of percentage decrease. First, we will write the given. What is the given in question? That is initial population. Initial population. What is the initial population? 25,000. This one is our initial population. And what is the decreased population? Decreased population is 24,500. So what is the loss in population? Loss in population means you have to subtract them. You can write difference in population also. You can write loss in population also. Both are right. Loss in population, or you can write difference in population. So 25,000 minus 24,500. So we will get 500. So this much is a decrease in population. Now we have to find decrease percentage. And what is the formula of decrease percentage? That is, in our formula, there is a change in amount upon original amount multiplied by 100. That I told you about the formula of decreasing percentage. Change in amount upon original amount multiplied by 100. But here it is not amount. Here it is a population. So we will write change in population. Change in population upon original population, or you can write initial population. Both are right. Initial population multiply by 100, because we have to find in percentage. So change in population is 500, and what was the initial? That is 25,000 multiply by 100. Now two zero cancel. Now on the table of 250, 1s are 250, 2s are 500. So our answer is 2%. So decrease in population is 2%. Now question number 4. We will start with question number 4. Next question 4. Arun bought a car for ₹3,50,000. The next year the price went up to. In the next year the price high. So that is 3,70,000. What was the percentage of price increase? In previous question there was a decrease in price, but here there is an increase in price. So price went up to. We will do similar we have done the previous question. First we will write initial price of a car. So initial price of car, that is ₹3,50,000. Now price went up to, it means that is the increased price. So increased price of car, that is ₹3,70,000. That is increased price. Now how much is price increased? We will subtract that. You can write there is a gain in price also, or you can write difference in price. Gain in price, or you can write difference. 3,70,000 minus 3,50,000. You will subtract it, you will get 20,000. So ₹20,000 is gain in price. Now formula, percentage increase. Or you can write increase percentage. Both are right. Increase percentage formula we will write change in amount. Or here you can also write change in amount. Change in amount upon original amount. That is initial. Original, or you can write initial. Multiply with 100. Now change in amount, that is ₹20,000 is change in amount. Now original amount is 3,50,000 is our original amount. Now 4040 cancel. Now on the table of 5 I am going to cancel. Now 20 into 2 is 40. So 40 upon 7%, or you can change into mixed fraction, that is 5 upon 7%. This is your question number 4. Now we will do 5th. Question number 5. Question is, I buy a TV for ₹10,000 and sell it at profit 20%. Now I buy a TV for ₹10,000. It means cost price is given to you. Buy means cost price. And selling price is not given to you, but profit percentage is given to you, 20%. How much money do I get for it? It means we have to find SP, that is selling price. First we will write given. What is given? Cost price of TV. That is ₹10,000. This one is our cost price of TV. And profit percentage. Profit percentage is 20%. Now here are two methods to solve this question. First with the formula direct. Other is, first we will find profit percentage. I will do both method. First the shortcut method, by direct putting the value in the formula. Now formula of SP, that is selling price, is 100 plus profit percentage multiply cost price upon 100. This is the formula, direct formula to find the SP. Now 100 plus profit percentage multiply CP upon 100. If in some another question there is a loss, then you will be write here minus and you will write here loss. When there is a case of loss, you will subtract. When there is a profit, you will add. So put the value profit 20 upon 100 multiply CP, that is 10,000. 100 plus 20 is 120. Now we will solve it. 20 cancel. So what it comes? 12,000. So selling price of TV is rupees 12,000. What is the another method? Another method, same you will be right, you can do in this method also. Cost price of TV, profit percentage. First you will write given. What is given? That one is our given. Now you will not write this formula. Now profit percentage is given to you, but profit in amount, how much money it is, that is not given to you. First we will find that. So first you will write CP of TV, that is rupees 10,000 in similar way. Then profit percentage is 20%. Then you will find profit. How you will find profit? Profit is always on cost price. Whenever we will find profit, that is on cost price. Or you know one more thing, that percentage is always find on the original amount, and that one is our cost price. So we will write profit. What is the profit? Profit is profit percentage of CP. Profit is profit percentage of cost price. What is profit percentage? 20% of 10,000. Remove percentage 100. Of means multiply. Two zeros cancel. What it comes? Rupees 2000. So it means what is the profit? That is rupees 2000. I have purchased a TV. Cost price of TV was 10,000. And I sold it at the profit of rupees 2000. Then what is the selling price? So we will find selling price. Selling price formula. Cost price plus profit. P means profit. C means cost price. SP means selling price. Now cost price was 10,000. Plus profit 2000. Add them. You will get rupees 12,000. So both answers are same, but there were two methods to solve one question. You can do in this method also. You can do in this method also. Today we will do till question number 5. Rest we will do later. Till then, bye.